Hi, everyone. My name is JJ Streicher-Bremer. I'm a Senior Customer Engineer with the Identity Advanced Cloud Engineering team, and today we're going to show IT admins what the App Passwords feature is and how to use it to enable multi-factor authentication for legacy applications. First, let's talk about when you would use App Passwords. Some legacy applications were not built to support modern multi-factor authentication. And app passwords allow us to use these applications even when multi-factor authentication is required. App passwords replace your traditional password and allow sign-in from the app to satisfy multi-factor auth. Applications that support modern authentication do not require app passwords since they are built to support the standard MFA process. If possible, our recommendation is to upgrade to apps that support modern authentication and thus do not use legacy authentication and require app passwords. This is because legacy authentication makes you more vulnerable to attack. Based on analysis of Azure Active Directory traffic, the risks of legacy authentication are stark. More than 99% of password spray attacks use legacy authentication protocols. More than 97% of credential stuffing attacks use legacy authentication. Azure AD accounts and organizations that have disabled legacy authentication experience 67% fewer compromises than where legacy authentication is enabled. Here are some considerations to remember if you decide to use app passwords. There is a limit of 40 app passwords per user. Applications that cache passwords and use them in on-premises scenarios can fail because the app password isn't known outside of Azure Active Directory. After MFA is enabled on a user's account, app passwords can be used with most non-browser applications, like Outlook and Microsoft Skype for Business. However, administrative actions cannot be performed by using app passwords through non-browser applications, such as Windows PowerShell. This is true even when the user has administrative privileges. App passwords are not automatically revoked when a user account password is reset. If you suspect that a user account is compromised and reset the account password, all app passwords should also be updated. The user should delete existing app passwords and create new ones. App passwords are automatically generated and cannot be specified by the user. This automatically generated password makes it harder for attackers to guess, so it is more secure, and users don't have to keep track of the passwords or enter them every time, as app passwords are only entered once per application. Now we're going to talk about how to enable the use of app passwords in our Azure AD tenant. The first step is to sign in to your Azure AD administrative portal, click on Users, and select multi-factor authentication. Depending on your screen resolution, this option might be hidden over under the ellipses on the right side. Once in the multi-factor authentication blade, click on Service Settings and click the radio button to allow users to create app passwords to sign in to non-browser applications and click Save. We also have to make sure that the user who will be using app passwords has MFA, multi-factor authentication, enabled. So let's go ahead and do that now. Now our user is ready to create and use app passwords. Now let's walk through the user experience for setting up an app password. The user is going to go to their proof up page in the Azure Active Directory portal. From here, they're going to click on App Passwords, click on Create, and give their app password a name. In this case, I'm creating one for Outlook 2010. Now the app password is available and ready for use. Please note that the user will only see this app password once and needs to keep a note of this so they can put it into their application. It's recommended that they actually have the application open and ready to use this app password when they go ahead and create it themselves. If your tenant has the combined security information registration experience enabled, your users may have a different UI experience. You can check this in your tenant by going to User Settings, selecting Manage User Feature Preview Settings, and looking at this setting right here, Combined Security Information Registration Experience. On newer tenants, this may be grayed out and set to all. If you have an older tenant, you have the option to choose None, Selected, or All. We recommend choosing All. If this is the case, users will get a slightly different user experience. To troubleshoot if the user doesn't have the ability to add an app password, one thing to check is to ensure that the user is actually enforced to use MFA. In this case, you can see Cloud One is only set to enabled. Once I enforce that user to use MFA, they will have the ability to create app passwords in their portal. I'll refresh the page to make sure it's updated. And then we can see that I now have the ability to add an app password. The user experience is going to be very similar. Again, here's the password. It will only appear once, and it's recommended that the user has the application up and ready to accept the password. I hope this video helps to explain the why, what, and how of app passwords, and will help you down the path of turning on multi-factor authentication in your environment. Thank you all for watching, and if there are any questions, please post them in the comments below.